Alright, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to this session, Discourse Analysis Subject. In this meeting, I would like to show you one presentation about one important aspect in doing discourse analysis. That is about the disciplines in discourse analysis. Let me show you the screen. Here we go. Let me do the slideshow. Okay. Right. So, in doing discourse analysis, there will be many kinds of activities that can cover the disciplines such as sociolinguistics, psycholinguistics, physical linguistics, computational linguistics, and that is according to Brown and Hume. So, when someone is doing discourse analysis, it will cover a wide range of meanings, a wide range of activities in order to describe the activities in the intersections of many kinds of disciplines, such as sociolinguistics, psycholinguistics, physical linguistics, computational linguistics, and it can be many other disciplines in linguistic study. Okay, so we can see that in doing discourse analysis, there will be many different kind of disciplines that are related to each other. And some of them are linguistic, sociolinguistic, psycholinguistic, linguistic anthropology, philosophy, history, literature, education, and law. As I explained in the previous presentation, that whenever we do discourse analysis, that is actually something relating to communication, interaction, our speech in a certain community. So whenever there are people who are interacting each other, communicate, speak each other, there will become the focus of doing discourse analysis. Okay. Right, Deitch, one of the experts in discourse analysis, in his book entitled Handbook of Discourse Analysis, said that discourse analysis will collect various works in terms of social psychology, sociology, sociocultural study, philosophy, history, and legal discourse. So many kinds of disciplines can be related to each other in order to do discourse analysis. Okay, Scriping also identifies some disciplines and areas of discourse analysis. For example, like in politics, media, medicine, language teaching, legal context, history, and also educational settings. In a specific case for language teachers in education, McCarthy state that there are some specific areas of discourse analysis. For example, by looking at the grammar, vocabulary, phonology, spoken language, and written language. Okay, now let's look at the first discipline in doing discourse analysis, that is in linguistics. According to McCarthy, there are three important aspects, or there are three important points in linguistic study that can be covered in doing discourse analysis. The first one is grammar, the second one is about vocabulary, and the third one is about phonology. Okay, in terms of grammar, people doing discourse analysis in terms of grammar in linguistic study can cover, for example, the grammatical cohesion. Yeah, it can be about textuality, about the use of tenses and aspects, pronouns, demonstratives, or many things in relation to the articles. It can also discuss about the use of conjunctions. So everything related to the use of grammar of the language in a certain speech communication can be analyzed in order to work in discourse analysis. In terms of vocabulary, okay. In terms of vocabulary, we can discuss about cohesion, lexis in the talk, the organization of the text, the modality, and of course about register, things like that. And in terms of phonology, whenever we are going to do work in discourse analysis in terms of the phonological aspects of the language of a certain language, we can discuss about, for example, pronunciation, the rhythm, the stress, the intonation, tones, and pitch. Yeah, that's about discourse analysis in linguistics. I go on. Okay, right, beside linguistics, sociolinguistics is also a kind of discipline that can be worked out in order to do the work of discourse analysis. As I say, sociolinguistics is the study of language in terms of society, the relations between the language in a certain situation. That is about sociolinguistics. Okay, so the work of discourse analysis in sociolinguistics will be directed toward the use of a particular language in a particular society. For example, we are going to see the differences in age, social status, gender, familiarity, or situation in relation to one aspect of communicative situation. Yeah, for example, in Bugis society, or in a certain community, for example, we are going to see how the differences in age, social status, or maybe gender, or maybe familiarity or situation in relation to the way they speak in a certain community. That's one focus. Okay. Here we go. There are some aspects for investigation in discourse analysis in the discipline of discourse analysis. For example, we can talk about dialects. The dialects of Bugis Makassar people in a certain community, we can discuss about that, we can analyze by using the work of discourse analysis. We can also analyze code switching in a certain community, the use of code switching, code crossing, code mixing in a particular community. Diglossia, register, the use of language in relation to the speech level, something like that, or maybe about sociolinguistic factors such as the relationship between gender in a certain community, and can also discuss about the variation of language use, for example, the use of slang in a certain community. Yeah, so those aspects can be investigated in terms of the disciplines of sociolinguistics, and it can be used in as the analysis in the discourse analysis. Okay, so here, this is an example of discourse analysis study in the field of sociolinguistics that had been conducted. For example, a study on speech levels such as in Japanese that had been conducted by Arrington. Those are the books, the year of the publication. Berman in 1998, Wajdi 2009 in Sundanese, and in West Timor, for example, by Mahyuni in 2003, and by Mahmud in 2008. That is about the use of politeness strategies in a Bugis community. So these are some of the examples of the focus of study of discourse analysis in the discipline of sociolinguistics. I go on. Okay. What is psycholinguistics? Psycholinguistics is the study about language comprehension. That is about the relationship between language and thought, language and mind. And that discipline can become an important aspect of discipline in doing discourse analysis. Okay, the example, how children age below 6 years old acquire their first and second language. Here, we can analyze, for example, the way they talk, the children, age 6 years old, how they communicate, how they produce their language, how are the strategies they use to communicate with the other children or to the older people, such as their parents, and can be also investigated in relation to the cultural aspect of the people. For example, children age below 6 years in a Makassar community, how they communicate each other with other children in a certain community, or maybe in other kinds of community, maybe in Mandar community, or maybe in Bugis community. Okay, see, so you can see here, this is the work of discourse analysis in psycholinguistics. This is only one example. I think there will be many other examples of study that had been conducted by many scholars in terms of discourse analysis. Okay, linguistic anthropology, or we can call it anthropology linguistic. Linguistic anthropology actually is the relation between anthropology and linguistic, and that's actually about the relation of language use in terms of the human culture. For example, anthropology is actually about the cultural life of the people, and the language or the linguistic is about the way they communicate, the way they use the language in terms of their cultural aspect. So that will be the relationship between language, culture, and society. Okay. And this discipline is an important discipline in terms of discourse analysis. We can analyze many aspects of language use in terms of the cultural life of the people in a certain community. Here is the example of the study that had been conducted by Berman in 1998 and also by Mahmoud in 2008. For example, the study of politeness practices in Bugis society by Mahmoud, and also the politeness practices of the people in Javanese society. And in this case, studies had been directed to find out how Bugis people or how Japanese people express their politeness influenced by the cultural aspect of Bugis or Japanese people. And in their analysis, they will use the approach or the method in doing discourse analysis. Okay, I continue. Philosophy. Okay, that's actually related to philosophical linguistics. And in this field, the main concern is about the relationship between language and its meaning, or maybe commonly known as the disciplines of semantics. Semantics is the study about meaning of the language. And for example, the example in this case is about the use of metaphors of any kinds of figure of speech in a particular text. And I think there will be many aspects in relation to semantic or the meaning of the words, the meaning of the sentences that can be analyzed by using the approach of discourse analysis. And these are the disciplines of philosophy. Okay, history. Yes, history is an important discipline in doing discourse analysis. For example, we can inquire the traditional texts of interpretation of the source and also the exploitation of archive or pertinent discourses that the historian used to reconstruct the past and also the presentation. Here, I can show you the example. Example of this doing discourse analysis in history in Bugis society. We have many kinds of traditional texts such as Attoriolong or maybe any other text written in Bugis Lontara. And those texts, for example, Lagaligo, can be analyzed by using the approach of discourse analysis. For example, how the way they communicate by using the language, or how they interpret the politeness in the past time of the Bugis society. Because, for example, Lagaligo is the very, very traditional work of Bugis society. And that is really, really important aspect in the historical life of the Bugis people. And in order to show you, in order to show us what is going on with the text, we can do analysis of the work by using discourse analysis. Okay, literature. Okay, literature is something related to the investigation of the usage of the literary works as resources of text for analysis. We know that there are many kinds of literary works such as poems, drama, short stories, novels, and all of them can be used as resources of text to analyze. So, for example, we can take one novel. The novel is read and then transcribed, and after that we analyze the way they communicate, the way the characters, for example, communicate in that novel. The movie script, for example, there is a movie, maybe the movie had been adapted from a certain novel. The movie had been transcribed into the text, and the text itself will be analyzed by using the approach of discourse analysis. And I think the students of English literature program will rely much on the use of literary work as their analysis. And of course, poems, drama, short stories, and novels that can become the source of data in the literature program can be analyzed by using discourse analysis. Okay, I go on. Yeah, here, yeah, this is the example. Drama can be used to analyze spoken discourse, and students can be assigned to perform one type of drama in the class. The performance can be recorded and interpreted later. And then the next activity will be about elaborating the transcribed text in relation to language use. So literature and linguistics, phonology, for example, in terms of morphology, and also the context of the language used in the literary work. Low, yeah, okay. This is usually known as legal context, and there will be many possibilities of occurring cases that can become the focus of doing discourse analysis in law or in legal context. For example, in the study of criminal cases, for example, the study can be focused in court hearings. A case of divorce, for example, may provide written and spoken discourse on reasons for sexual harassment in the family. Yeah, something like that. The recording of the certain case in a criminal case. I remember there was very tragedy. The case of Jessica Kumala Wongso. Yeah, and then the TV at the time broadcasted the process of the court hearings, and then at the time there were many aspects, and there are many experts that are related to each other in order to see whether Jessica Kumala Wongso is actually the person who murdered the victim at the time. So I think this is one of the example. And I think there will be many aspects. There will be many cases that can be that can become the source of discourse analysis in law. Yeah. Whenever we study about discourse analysis in legal context, we can focus on the use of speech acts, for example, the way they promise, offer, deny, agree, threatening, warning, apologizing as evidence in criminal cases. Yeah, I think this is really, really interesting. How can, for example, the person who conducted the criminal case try to defend themselves in order not to be categorized as the victim or something like that. Yeah. Okay. Education. Yes, education. I think teachers will work much on the work of discourse analysis, because education is one of the fields that is usually discussed in discourse analysis. And I think according to Rogers, yeah, educational contexts are potential sources of studying discourses, because in the class, in educational context, there will be interaction between teachers and students. There are documents about the curriculum, also about the institutional meetings, and the focus can be in the class activities such as the way the teachers teach in the class, and also the way the students learn in the class, whether by using group discussion, the group discussion of the teachers, conducted by the teachers, and also with the students, can be recorded and can become the source of doing discourse analysis. And at the moment, mostly teachers use online sources in teaching, online teaching, using, for example, the facility of Zoom or maybe Google Meet, the way that can be used in order to analyze the teaching activities of the teachers in online teaching can be by, for example, taking the video recording of the online, or maybe transcribing the text used by the teachers in communicating with the students in WhatsApp in WhatsApp application, and also maybe their way to discuss in the Zoom meeting, things like that. And that's become the very, very potential source in doing discourse analysis in education. And of course, teachers and students' interaction in the class will cover, for example, the way they answer the question, the way the lecturing in the class, yeah, and also maybe the class discussion or the group discussion. Many kinds of activities in education can become the source of discourse analysis. Next, politics. Yeah, I think politics is one of the potential fields of exploring discourses. Activities in political matters can provide critical areas and issues to be potentially explored in relation to discourse. And of course, in this discipline, the ideas of power relation will become the important point in doing discourse analysis. Yeah, for example, the political debate, yeah, of the president candidates. Yeah, usually now before the election, there is usually a debate broadcasted in television, how the two candidates try to promote their programs, yeah, after being elected as the president. And I think there are some programs that concern a lot about politics, such as Indonesian Lawyers Club. In Indonesian Lawyers Club, usually there is a topic in relation to the politics, something relating to social, and then there will be many other presenters, there will be also many other speakers who try to give solutions to the problems. And those activities can be recorded, and of course, that will be good resource in doing discourse analysis in terms of politics. Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah. Well, so one example of study in this political discourse is the study of Obama's speech by Yuli Mar and Ginting in 2009. Okay, let's see. Ginting in his study found some differences in the ways the two presidents, Obama and the former Indonesian president, Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono, delivered their speech in their inauguration day. And some of the differences can be seen in terms of politeness, the use of identity and group markers, promising, offering, and so on. So I think the work of discourse analysis in politics will give many, many interesting cases. Yeah, because people like to debate about politics, about the election, for example. Yeah, something like that. So there will be many, many cases, there will be many aspects of communication that can be observed, that can be analyzed by using discourse analysis in politics. Okay, now, well, I have come to the end of my presentation. So, if I can conclude, yeah, if I conclude in this presentation, I will say that there are many disciplines. There are a lot of disciplines in doing discourse analysis. All things are related to the use of language in a certain way of communication. In a certain place, for example, in terms of education, then that's about the teachers and the students. And when in terms of the politics, that will be about the interaction between maybe the presidents, the candidates of the presidents, yeah. Things like that. So for the students, I think because here this students of English literature program, so maybe the most important source of doing discourse analysis is in the form of literary work. Students can concentrate on one kind of movie script, and then they can bring analysis. They can analyze the characterization, the concept of ideas, the ideologies, the conflicts in the literary work by using the work of discourse analysis. And I think other disciplines such as linguistics and sociolinguistics can also be integrated with other disciplines in order to create good work in doing discourse analysis. Okay. Yes, so that's all about my presentation at the moment about the disciplines of discourse analysis. Hopefully, all of you can take benefits from this presentation, and remember, there will be some other videos about the work of discourse analysis. Perhaps we need to take a look on the methods in doing discourse analysis. After we know about the discourse, what is discourse, the concepts and also the approaches in doing discourse analysis, the disciplines, the area and the issues that can be discussed in this discourse analysis, of course, we need to know the methods, the procedures in doing discourse analysis in order to produce good work and high qualified work in discourse analysis. Thank you very much for your attention. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.